as a thrill, as unknown it'll be. Well, I'll be, if it isn't the wonderful Mr. William Elliot Whitmore. How are you, bud? We got to get you to unmute somehow. I might have that already stuck. I don't know if you've done this before or not, but there we go. This happens.
There we go.
Well, there you are. How are you?
I'm doing well. Sorry it took me a minute to get going there. I'm sure you guys are used to doing this. I haven't done a lot of this, so I apologize for being late to the meeting.
Oh, it's okay. We're just glad you're here. We've been learning a little bit about you. We created an assignment on Wednesday where we like watched you, and then we got to think about what, you know, some facts about you, and then ask some questions and do some writing based on you. So we got to know who you are now.
Oh, well, that's amazing. I'm really honored. I appreciate it. Does this sound okay? Everything coming through all right?
Yeah, it sounds great. It sounds really good. Yeah.
Well, I'm really honored to be doing this, and I just want to say hello to everyone that's on this meeting here. And you guys are out there in Oregon, right?
Yes, sir. We are in McMinnville, Oregon, like 2,000 miles away from you. And yeah, we can use Zoom to connect with artists. It's pretty neat.
I think it is a cool thing. You know, during these crazy times, there's a lot of negativity and a lot of negative things, but this is one of the positive things we can do. And I'm just honored you asked me to do this. I really like Oregon a lot. I like where you guys are at. I miss traveling. That's one of the things with this whole mess. I miss traveling, and I miss places like Oregon. So this is a good way to connect in the meantime till we can see each other in person again.
Yeah, for sure. It's difficult as a teacher to redesign everything kind of every day because we're not used to doing it. We didn't sign up for this. So I got kind of creative and decided, why don't we like pick every week a new theme in music, and we'll just guide our teaching that way and see if some people want to join us to explain their craft and play some for us. And so this week is blues week, and you're kind of a little bit of a few things, but definitely have a blues sound. So thanks for coming on for that.
Of course. And I just want to say that you're doing such good work. Being a teacher is so hard. Being a student is so hard right now too. I mean, it's just hard for everyone. So I want to commend all the students, everyone that's on here, for being real troopers and just sticking with all this craziness. And I want to commend Mr. Harney as well for coming up with a creative way to teach something. Yeah, Mr. Harney.
Oh, stop. Okay.
Look. So you guys are talking about blues. Now, yeah. I love this. Because so much of music, whether you know it or not, is rooted in the blues. Like, you've probably been learning about some of this. But so much of what you like, so much modern music is rooted in the blues. And it was invented with very simple tools and under some very stressful situations as well. I mean, our current time is very stressful and hard, and we know that. But what some people did a long time ago is they took those hardships and those stresses and turned it into music. And that's what blues is. And I'm sure you've learned all this already, but it can't be said enough that the people that invented this were going through really hard times. And throughout the years, you know, rock and roll, punk rock, hip hop music, it all comes from the blues, soul music, which you guys will be studying soul music next week. That's an offshoot of the blues. I mean, it really all comes from this. And so what I do has some blues elements for sure. And even though I've mixed it with folk and country and some other things, but it's really blues based. And so, I'm just glad to talk about it.
Yeah, excellent way to explain it. We had a guy on yesterday who explained it like water. He said, whatever you're drinking has water in it, and almost whatever you're listening to has blues in it. So they're very similar.
And I thought that's a great way to put it. It's very elemental. It's, yeah, very, you know, cool. we're all actually made of the same cells and stardust. You know, we're all made of the same stuff. And music is all made of the same notes, the same basic elements, but it's just a matter of what order do you put them in and how do you express it? And I like that idea that it's all very elemental. And so the blues definitely has its fingers in everything. Every music you have heard of today has blues elements to it.
Wonderful. Well, would you like to play us a song and we can see how bluesy this is?
Sure. Well, I'm gonna do so I hope this isn't too loud. Wave your hands or something if it's too loud, but we'll see. This song's called Country Blues.
To spend, for tomorrow might be Sunday, and I won't have a dollar or a friend. 'Cause when I've got plenty of money, good people, my friends all gather around. But as soon as my pocketbook is empty, not a friend in this world can be found. The last time I seen my woman, good people, she had a wine glass in her hand. She was drinking down her troubles with a low down sorry man. Come around this old jailhouse and see me, good people. $40 won't pay my fine. Corn liquor's drowning my body. Pretty women been troubling my mind. Listen to my mother, good people. Well, I wouldn't be here today with that shooting and drinking and gambling. At home, I cannot stay. So go dig a hole in the middle, good people. Dig it deep in the cold, cold ground. Come gather around, you fine friends, and watch this old scoundrel go down.
Wow, that was awesome. Amazing.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, that's an old, old song. I did not write that one. But it's called Country Blues, and it's changed over the years. A lot of these old songs, you know, over the course of 100 years, the lyrics get changed. People remember them differently, and the song changes. It's almost like an organic thing, you know. And so that's an old, old song that I've always liked playing. And it definitely is a blues song, but I do it with my instrument, which is the banjo. I do play guitar as well, but the banjo was a blues instrument as well. I mean, it comes from Africa, you know, as did the people that invented this music under very stressful situations. Let's not mince words. But that was my version of an old song.
Wonderful. Well, one thing I taught the kids to do before you came on was to raise a glass and just, you know, cheers a little bit. So hopefully we can cheers you for that beautiful tune.
Well, this is what we do at shows when we used to have shows. So what I have here is a lime LaCroix. So I'm going to have that. And I just want to thank all you students. You know, you people you're awesome. Thank you for tuning in here. Cheers.
Awesome. I got me one of them sparkling waters too, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. You know, these things are pretty good.
I like those bubbles.
Yeah. It's good. And so What age group are most of the folks, like 7th, 8th, 9th grade?
We have mostly 8th graders here. I think we have a couple high schoolers, maybe younger high schoolers that streamed in. And I usually invite some 7th or 6th graders, but let me turn on the gallery view just to take a look here. Is anybody not in 8th grade that's a student out here? Nathan. Okay, let's ask Nathan really quick what grade he's in. Can we do that? Hey, Nathan. Hi, bud. Can you unmute and tell us what grade you're in?
Okay, say hi.
Hi.
Can you say what grade are you in?
I'm better.
She's in sixth grade.
That's a fifth grade.
Oh, awesome. Well, welcome. Welcome to this. Thank you for tuning in and to all the, you know, the parents at home that are helping. Some people are doing it on their own. Some people have their parents helping. Thank you all for doing this. And that's great. Sixth, seventh, eighth grade. That's a good age. But I know it's been a hard year for everyone. And I don't know. I just can't help but think about how difficult it's been, but we can have these moments of happiness and these moments of goodness and maybe learn a couple things about music too.
Yeah, that's the idea for sure. Well, we got a couple of my kids in here. Oh, we might have Kaiden here too. Hey, Kaiden, are you? Let's ask him real quick. He's kind of new to us. Hey, buddy. Am I saying it right? Kaiden? Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, what grade are you in, Kaiden? Is that sixth grade? Seventh. Okay. Well, we're glad you're here. We're super glad you're here. I know that some of my students had some questions that they've been working on. So if we could just take a minute to ask a couple questions and then maybe another song or two and see how that rolls. Let's see. Kaylee, do you remember your question? You're usually spot on. So, and John's got a question. We'll do Kaylee and John.
Yes, I remember my question. Okay. How long have you played music for? And where did you get your banjo?
That's a good question. Thank you for that. I've been playing music for about 30 years. About 30 years, which even as I say it, that doesn't seem right, but it's been a long time. It's been about 30 years. I'm 42 years old, and I started when I was about 12. And that's around, you guys are 12, 13-ish. That's around you guys' age, around there, is when I started playing guitar and banjo. And my first banjo belonged to my grandfather, who was a musician as well. And so I was lucky. He had one that I could use. And my father played the guitar as well. So they were just around. And that's kind of why I think I got into it. But I was around your age when I started, which was about 30 years ago. And so it's been a long time. Gosh, now that I think about it, that's a long time. But that's a good question. And I have a lot of banjos, as you can maybe see. I've collected a bunch of them over the years. Some of them I've inherited. I have my grandfather's original banjo and several others that I've gotten over the years. And this one I bought to take on tour with me. I used to tour a lot back when we could do that. And I'll be doing it again here sometime. But this one I got from a catalog, basically. But I've collected a lot of them over the years. But that's a good question. Thank you for that.
John will have one more question here. John, he uses a device to ask questions, so we got to kind of tune in here. John, let's get your – where'd you go? You got a question, bud?
Right over here.
What kind of animal do you have on your farm and how many? We have goat, chicken, and horse.
Oh, wow. That's amazing. You have goats, chickens, and horses on your place? That's so great. I love that question. Thank you so much for that question too. So on my farm, we just have horses and we have chickens and dogs. And that's what we have. When I was little, we had pigs and we had horses as well. But yeah, pigs and chickens, but we don't have pigs anymore. But now I have chickens and horses. And so I'm kind of jealous of you having goats too. That's pretty cool. I just really like animals. I grew up on a farm. I still live here. And I just really like animals. And, you know, I don't care what kind of animal, cats, dogs, fish, lizards, whatever you got, hamsters, they're all really cool. But here I have two horses and six chickens and a dog. And so it's pretty amazing. I sure like hanging out with them. And that's a great question. Thank you for that.
I was listening to Solar Flare off your latest album, and you talk about maybe falling off your horse. I hope that you can stay on that horse, okay?
Yeah, you know, sometimes we use metaphors to speak of things, and especially in songs. And, you know, so I definitely do that. And, you know, falling off your horse can mean any stumbling block in life. And it's just a matter of picking yourself back up, getting back on the horse, and not quitting and keeping going. And it's a hard thing to do, but if you can get back on the horse and keep going, it's a good thing. So that had to do with, I used that in that song, but I don't think I've ever literally fallen off a horse. I've been kicked by a horse a long time ago. I've been pushed by a horse, but never fallen off one. So that's good.
Have you ever been bit by a horse? That happened to me once.
I have. And it was my fault. The horse probably, you know, I probably wasn't approaching the horse correctly or something. It was my fault. You know, the horse wasn't to blame. Although horses can be ornery. They can be mischievous. You know, they can be up to no good once in a while. But usually it's the human's fault if something goes wrong. But yeah, you don't want to get bit by no horse. That's bad news.
That hurts. All right. Well, if you got another song about horses or whatever, we would love to hear it, my friend.
Yeah. All right. You know, I was going to do a different song, but you said that one, and I'm going to, this one's called My Mind Can Be Cruel to Me. So I don't normally do that one on the banjo, but I'm going to try it for you right now. This is an exclusive here. I wrote this one. I thought I saw your ghost from the corner of my eye, sitting in your rocking chair. You were reading, bury my heart at wounded knee. I turned my head, but you weren't really there. My mind is cruel to me. My mind can be cruel to me. I swear I heard your voice calling out to me from somewhere long ways away. I followed the sound, but you were nowhere to be found. I swear I heard something on that day. My mind is cruel to me. There's some nights that just won't leave me be. Well, most times it's fine, but it's a very thin line. My mind can be cruel to me. I dreamt we were riding horses across the western plains, camping at night, sitting around the fire, singing home, home on the range. I woke up to find it wasn't so. It's a feeling that I intimately know. My mind is cruel to me. My mind can be cruel to me. Well, the fabric of reality is stretching pretty thin. I can't believe the things that I see. It ain't permanent. The shape I'm in, I can't seem to trust my memory. My mind is cruel to me. There's some nights that just won't leave me be. Well, most times it's fine, but it's a very thin line. My mind can be cruel to me. My mind can be cruel to me. Thank you. So that one has a little more of a few drops of country music added into that. But again, it's all rooted in blues music. And so, if it's all a big pot of chili, you know, you're adding ingredients, and that's got a few drops of country music in it too.
We're going to study country in a few weeks. So we'll be listening for that sound for sure.
Oh, good. Well, you guys, by then, you'll have such a good foundation of what the building blocks of music are. I wonder if it's, I hope it's interesting, you know, to learn about, because to me, it's so much of my life is music, and it makes me feel so good. And I like all types of music. I like rap music and punk music and heavy metal and folk music and pop music. I really can find something I like in all of those things, and it makes me feel so good. So I hope you guys feel that way too. I wonder if you do, and I hope that learning this stuff gets you closer to that, like puts you more in touch with the music and makes you feel even better. And so by the time you get, you'll do soul next week, you'll do country music. By the end of this, you'll know so much about it. So that makes me happy.
Me too. All right, we got a couple questions that we prepared. I hope that we can give good energy to this guy. And hopefully he can pull this off, okay?
I'm gonna good energy coming your way.
Do this, Jack. We're going to check on you here. Jack, do you have your question for Mr. Whitmore? Okay. I was hoping. A little shy. But here is his question, because he did a great job developing this. Jack, you got one more chance here. You want to ask this? I think you can do it. I believe in you.
Yeah, we believe in you. Good energy. We believe in you.
Okay. Well, his question is a really good one, Will. It is, how does it feel to have a good career?
Oh, well, that is a good question. I'll let you know when I get one. That's a joke. That is a great question. I appreciate that question. That's very thoughtful. I'm so lucky. I've been doing this professionally for over 20 years now. And it started with not very many people wanting to listen. And slowly over time, a few more people wanted to listen, and then a few more and a few more. And it got to where I could really go to different cities and have a lot of people come and listen and enjoy themselves. So to me, that's a good career. And at the end of the night, I get paid. And that allows me to pay my, buy groceries and things. And so to me, that's success. You know, if you can be happy at what you're doing and continually innovate and make good music, in my case, you know, try to make the best music I can and have fun doing it, that's success. And that's a good career. I'm not a millionaire. I live on a farm with my wife and daughter, and I'm not rich by any means, but I can pay my bills and I can write songs and have fun doing it. And that is a good career in my book. And so it just feels nice. It feels nice. And every one of us, everyone that's listening and watching, you have something in you that you can give the world. You have something you can offer. I know it. I know you do. And so if you can give that to the world and share your gift, whatever that is, it's a good thing. And it's a good feeling. Finding that in yourself, it's a journey, you know, but you each have something in you that makes people happy, and it's some gift you can share. So if you can do that and be happy, that's a good career. And so I feel thankful to be able to do that. That's a good question. Thank you.
Better raise a glass to that one, Mr. Whitmore. That was beautiful words by you there.
Cheers.
I love that I'm hydrating so much here. All right, we have a teacher with a question. One of my coworkers, collaborators, Miss O'Connor, if she can ask a question too. The adults have questions too, you know. So we'll see if she's
able. Yeah, of course. I welcome it. Thank you.
So my daughter and I were wondering, what inspires you when you write your songs?
Oh, that's a great question. That's a great question. It could be anything. When you're a writer, a songwriter, any kind of artist, really, if you're a photographer or if you're a painter of pictures, anything, you try to get inspiration from anywhere you can. And so my mind works in a way where it might be a really beautiful sunset, something as trite as that. It might be the sound of my 10-month-old daughter's voice. It might be watching her play. That might be inspiring. It might be walking in the woods around my farm and seeing the squirrels play in the trees. Anything like that could spark an idea or spark a line of poetry or lyric that might spark a song, you know. And to take it back to blues, sometimes it's not a happy thing. It's okay to feel sad sometimes and feel, just feel disillusioned sometimes. And that's okay. We all do that. But the thing you can try to do is channel that into something healthy, like channel that bad feeling into something good. Paint a picture, write a song, write a poem, do a blog post, take a photo. But channeling those sad feelings into art is important as well. And that's to bring us back to what the blues is. A lot of that was what they were doing. And so I could be inspired by, it could be a death in the family. It could be something sad as well. That's heavy. I know that's heavy, but you guys can handle it. But we take those sad things and we channel it in a healthy way. That's the thing, you know, and because we all feel that way sometimes, and that's okay. But mostly it's good stuff. And so to answer your question, it could be so many things. And that's what good art, to me, that's what where good art comes from. It could be a good book I read, you know, or anything like that. So that's kind of a broad answer to your question, but it really could come from anywhere.
I would just summarize that by listening to life, you know, and
yeah. And it's got a lot to say, life. life has a lot to say, a lot of good, some bad, and that's okay. But channeling even the sadness into something good, that's what music's good for. You know, we all have those feelings sometimes, and that's all right. But you move through it, you get past it, and we live to work another day, you know.
Well, we've kept you for a little while here. We appreciate your time. I don't know if you could maybe take us out with one more, and we could say we're so glad we met you and goodbye and all that, but...
Sure. I'm honored to have done this. I know you talked to my friend David Zolo not that long ago or whenever. He is a good friend and a great guy. I bet he had a lot to say.
Oh, yeah, he was awesome. He was one of our first ones. He stepped right up and was like, yeah, this is a great idea. Let's do it. So
he is one of my best friends. We're in a band together. And I've known him for years and years. We've played a lot of music together. He's one of my favorite guys in the world, and a very intelligent and thoughtful man. So that's cool that you talked to my buddy Dave. Okay, so let's see. I wasn't ready for a third one. Let me think of something appropriate here. Let's do something impossible. Let's do something impossible. Let's do something grand. Let's bet it all on one horse. 'Cause you and
and me, you and me, we're gonna win, of course. Was a miracle. We'll escape from Alcatraz just like Theodore Cole. We'll have what no one else has. We will be. Of the free. We'll keep our knife blades sharp. Oh, we'll keep our gunpowder dry. And when Custer comes over the hill, oh, let him fly. Oh, boys, let your arrows fly. Let's do something impossible. Let's do something grand. Let's do something impossible. Let's do something grand.
Wonderful.
Thank you. This is to you. I'm applauding you guys.
A lot. Well, I want you to know that we plan on getting an album of yours for our classroom, like we do with all of our artists, and having something tangible to reflect on and relive, and you know, continue to teach your words and your songs to our students for years to come. So you're going to be a part of this classroom for a while.
Well, that's an honor. That really is an honor. Email me. I'll send you something for free. I can send you some stuff. I'll donate it. You know, just come to my website or email me, and I'll give me your address and I'll send you some stuff. But that's a big honor. And I just want to thank each and every one of you for sticking with this. This was either boring or exciting, depending on how you feel. But I'm honored to have been a part of your day a little bit. And email me and I'll send you whatever you want.
That's really kind of you. Let's raise one more glass to Mr. Whitmore before we send him off. Stay warm out there. I know y'all got some snow. So.
Yep. We do. Cheers, y'all. Here's to you. Here's to you.
What a beautiful morning. All right, my friend, take care of yourself. Congratulations on the new child, and best of luck to you. Hopefully we run into each other soon out here.
We will. I promise we will. Best of luck to you all, too. See you next time.
Take care.